Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we will see how to use options like break cell, make cell, break symbol and make symbol. Okay. For understanding that, I am taking one object. Here, one more object. Now, as you can see here, we have two different objects. If I double click on that, for that particular animation links will open. As you can see, object name is also graph 5125, and if you see for that object here also graph is 5126, means object name and animation links is different, means here I can give separate properties for that particular object. Now I want that I will use both the objects together, means I have to make T. Okay, now I will be able to give the property for that particular T only, means it will work as a complete symbol. For that, what you have to do, you have to select all objects together, then you have to go for right click, then as you can see here, make break option is there, so you have to click on make symbol. Okay, now if you move together T, okay, it is a complete symbol. If you double click on that, as you can see, name is also different, 5127. Okay, so you can provide now property for that symbol. Okay, likewise, if you want to break, right click, go to make cell, make break, then click on break symbol. Now as you can see, if you select one, both are different symbols. Okay, that is break symbol. Now for understanding break cell and make cell, okay, just delete this. Now here my objective is that when I move this small rectangle from this point to top position of that big rectangle, my value will change from 0 to 100, means it will work as a slider. Okay, so for that, double click, go to sliders vertical. Okay, first you have to measure the length. We will discuss later how to give that property. Just now I am defining you how to use break cell and make cell. Okay, so vertical, so here I am providing 290, so we have to go up to 290. Now we have provided property there, okay, but by mistake if I move that object from this position to this position, okay, now if you go in touch view, right click, go to switch to view, picture, open, click on okay. Now as you can see, my object is moving, okay, but okay, before doing that, we will take here text value for showing the value. Change the color. Okay, now provide value display property. Now save. Now if you go to switch to view, okay, as you move your small box, your value is changing, but here is by mistaken we have moved that object from this point to this point. So it is not reaching up to last point of that object. So what we can do in this, I will take this original position. Okay, now after that I will select both of them, right click, go to make sale. Okay, after making sale, as you can see it is working a separate symbol, means both are different symbols. This is a different symbol, that one is a different symbol, but here we have created sale for both of symbol, means whatever property, animation property you have given to that symbols, it will remain there. If you used make symbol here, that property will go to both of the objects. That is the difference between make cell and make symbol. Means in make cell, when you are creating make cell, if you provided different properties to two different objects, that property will remain same for objects. When you are working with make symbol, same property will go to both objects. Means we are not able to provide different property in different objects. In Excel we can do that. Okay, so if you check that one, now as you can see so likewise we can use break cell and break symbol. Again if you have to change the property, you can click on break symbol, symbol position, break symbol, break cell. So as you can see, if you double click on that, your animation links will not come. Means after creating cell, we are not able to change the property. Once you have done make cell, you are not able to change the property again. For that you have to first break cell. Okay, so that is the difference between make symbol and make cell.